work out, they do it every time.
Good evening, family. This is Stan Matthews on the Matthews Broadcast, Empowerment Broadcasting. And we are here at 91.7 FM, Gems Radio, and we are streaming worldwide on the World Wide Web at www.gemsradio.net. You can watch and listen to the broadcast at the Gems Radio Facebook page, and that is gemsradio.net. And you could see all of the past episodes of the show. All of the segments are up on YouTube at the Stan Matthews Broadcast. So we're going to get right into it as we usually do. We are here to empower and enrich you with good advice, good information, very positive people, very positive concepts. The whole thought process of the Matthews Broadcast is one in which we focus on the light and we focus on the right. We focus on those things that all of us find as blessings. As we always remind you, you are a world changer, but nothing changes until you change it, world changer. You cannot just sit back and wait for someone else to do it for you. When everything is falling apart, a good friend of mine said, to me, a little while ago, she said, I had to become my own superhero. So what she wanted in life wasn't exactly happening the way that she wanted it to happen. And so Sister Lisa, I think her name is, said I had to become a superhero for me and my daughter. So she did. And so all of us have that superhero locked inside. And I see this beautiful young lady here, Kia, in the studio with us, so I know I have another superhero with me who's also a world changing mom, so I'm glad to have both. And we'll get to our guests in a moment. Second thing to remember, as I always tell you, be careful that you work on making people feel that love, making that feel that appreciation, giving them that recognition for who they are. So as I always remind you, family, our poet laureate Maya Angelou said to us a long time ago, people will forget what you said, they may forget what you did, but they will never, ever forget how you made them feel. So make sure that you are working on passing positive feelings on to everyone that you meet. My grandfather told me a long time ago that loving and giving is good for the heart and definitely good for the bottom line. So loving and giving is good for the heart and also good for the bottom line. Always has been, always will be. Finally, we need to get wealth. One of the themes of the Matthews Broadcast is urban communities need more investment. They need more wealth. Urban communities in the United States of America represent roughly a third of a $19 trillion economy. Last year, people who live in big cities spent into the American economy roughly $3.2 trillion. That is a lot of money. But the problem is much of it doesn't stay beyond 24 hours in urban communities. As soon as we get it, we spend it with everyone else, and they take wheelbarrows full of money and they leave the community. And the community ends up looking the way it does in many cases, and the crime rates go through the roof. The schools are poor because we can't invest. So we've got to have wealth, and we've got to invest in our communities. And so that is one of the themes here. Finally, while we need financial wealth, we have to remember those fruit of the spirit are something that we also need. And those are things that money cannot buy. And that's unconditional love of a daughter, the unconditional love of a mother. That is respect. That is honor. That's true friendship. My image doctor over there is my true friend. I don't go anywhere without him. I feel a little naked if I have Cornelius around. But those are things that dollars can buy. We just have a real friendship. Anthony Romance Chain, if you're listening, you are part of my circle of love. Always have been, always will be, from the time we met 1982 on the campus of Kane. And so things are just not right in my world unless my brother Roe is around. So if you're listening out there, hope you and Linda and the kids are having a great night. Hope to see you very soon upon my return. In studio tonight, we have Miss Tracy Wilcox, and we have Miss Kia, her daughter, that's coming along to make sure that I don't say anything about her mother so I can get in trouble. You know, in our community, if you say something about somebody's mother, that's the fight will start promptly. So, so I'm glad to have both of you. Tracy's business is Diamondback Massage Therapy. She's a recently incorporated business, and it sounds to me she's in the business of making people relax and making people feel comfortable. And Kia's in the business of making sure that her mom is all right. We are glad to have Kia in the house. Tracy, tell me, what made you interested in going into massage therapy?
Well, I first want to start off by saying thank you for having me on the show.
Glad to have you.
God is awesome.
All the time.
As a young person, you know, we all have a story. We all have a path and everything. And I've always been one to want to help people, no matter what it was. I always felt some kind of compassion to people. Life didn't take me on the doctor path, you know, but as, you know, I got older, I did various things. I wound up, you know, having two beautiful children, and those were my priorities. But I always knew that I needed to go into a healing profession because that's where my heart is. You know, when a person cries, I cried. When a person came with a sorry story or something, I felt it, you know. But again, my priority was my children. So when my daughter turned 16, I said, Mommy is going to school. And I was 45 at the time. And so I went to school, and it took me a minute to find what kind of school, because not all schools make you feel like you're home, you know. So I found the school, Anthems Institute in Jersey City, and right then and there, I knew that's where I needed to be. That's where it was going to stem from. That's where my new life was going to take place. And then I graduated with my license, and I'm just so honored to have chosen that profession. And, you know, it just makes me so overwhelmed because the way that I touch people's lives and make that impact is so heartwarming to me and for me, you know.
You know, I was in Las Vegas last year. It's weird to say last year when you're January. But last year was only a month ago, right? So I was in Vegas last year, and I went to a place called Shangri-La. Someone invited me to come to Shangri-La with him, a friend that I've known a long, long time, had moved to Vegas because he needed that dry air. He was having some problems with his lungs. So ran into him, and, you know, we reconnected. He said, you know, meet me over here. We're going to go. And the person in Shangri-La, they were teaching us all of the systems in the body that could be strengthened by touch. And then what really blew my mind is she started talking about, Korean woman, she started talking about what's in your feet. And she showed us a chart with some with a set of feet, and she showed everywhere you can touch on that chart where it would affect another organ in the body. That's from foot massage.
Reflexology.
You know, so it was incredible, and in terms of the information and the wisdom that this woman had. So tell me the magic of touch. So reflexology is something obviously you're familiar with, and all the things that you
on a basic level, like when I do my assessment, because like when clients come to me, I do an assessment of them. Once I get them on the table, I kind of channel my energy. You know, it's not like you tailor make a session, because you can't do that, because I'm really trying to do healing. So I channel my energy towards that. And once I get like to the feet, I do a little bit of reflexology, because on the feet, like say on your toes, those are your sensories. Okay, in between your toes tells me if you have any lymphatic issues, upper lymphatic issues. I could tell if you're having problems in the pelvic area, you know, or whatever. So when people say, oh, I have a bunion, I say, you know, no, it could be something else. I never diagnose anything. But at the same time, I know what I know. So, and I give that back to the client. You know, I say, hey, are you having any problem with your jaw? Because this is what I'm feeling, and your toe is telling me this. And they're like, yeah, how did you know? You know, I'm like, well, you know, this is what your body gives off. You know, so it's amazing what I do. I love what I do. You know, people come to me because I specialize in trigger point therapy of the back. And basically, trigger points are taut bands of muscle fiber that hold in toxins and can create pain, acute and chronic. You know, and I have a lot of people that come to me and say, you know, well, I went to the doctor and I told them my back was bothering me really bad. It's been like that for a week. And they don't know what's wrong, but they think I have sciatic. Mm. And then I'm like, okay, so I start working on them, challenging my energy towards an area, because muscles are, they're inventive little things, you know? And there's certain muscles that I will go to that I know that this area could be a problem, like especially with the back, because the pain could be coming from the legs, the glute area, or the back, or all three. So, you know, you kind of, well, how I do it, I kind of run through everything and strip every muscle, you know. So it's not just a petrissage or effleurage type of treatment with me. You know, it's really, I'm trying to get directly to where the pain source is coming from, because just because you have pain in your back, the trigger point could be in your leg. You know, if you have pain in your neck, the trigger point could be coming from the arm.
Let me ask you a question. Yes. Now, when I go in the gym in the morning, I go very early in the morning. I love to train legs, right?
Okay.
But last night was a primary example. About, I'm an early riser, so I'm usually up about 4:30, 5 o'clock every day. Okay. But right at around 3:15 last night, I rolled to the right and my right leg just completely locked up with cramp, right? So I had to get up, I had to get some liquid, I had to shake it out, you know, it took some time. But what I find is that there's acid or something there, because the soreness lasts for a long time. Now, in your therapy, how do you move that out of your system? Is it just a question of drinking a lot of liquids?
No, I'm going to ask you what I ask my clients. Mm-hmm. And it's the $1 million question. You go to the gym, you work out. Do you stretch?
Yes.
Okay, do you stretch before or after?
Both.
Do you stretch more after or more before?
More before.
Okay, that's the wrong answer. You should stretch more after, because you want to lengthen the muscles. Because when you're working out, you're constantly contracting. Mm-hmm. You know, you after your workout, you want to stretch more harder at the end of your session to allow your muscles to lengthen back. You know?
But does it move that acid out of the system? Like, what gets that? Because this is what the trainer says, that soreness is an acid.
I don't know about acid. Yeah. I don't know about acid. It could be muscle tension, or you're having muscle spasm, you know. But I never heard about acid.
Your suggestion is just stretch.
My suggestion would be stretch. And if there is inflammation, ice is our best friend. Mm-hmm. You know, use ice. Never put heat on inflammation, because it encourages inflammation.
More. You get.
So, you know, ice is our best friend. I tell my clients this, you know, all the time. So, and you know, I mean, do you even get massages? Because massage is not just about relaxation and things like that. It's really for longevity. You know, let me see. People like Jack Lane, that lived for a long time. I mean, yeah, he could afford it, but he had a massage every day, you know. So it's a necessity at this point. It's for your life at this point, really, you know. And a lot of people don't realize it, you know. And I tell a lot of my clients, mm-hmm. you know, when they come to me and they say, you know, I've been seeing this doctor. I mean, doctors are great. and all. You don't get me wrong. You know there's a but. But, you know, I feel as though, even as a massage therapist, I took an oath to help people get back healthy as much as possible. I mean, I know there's sicknesses and illnesses that we need the doctors and everything, but I tell my clients, if your doctor can't sit you down and have a conversation with you, if your doctor is eager to write that prescription, run. Just run, you know, because you have to care about a person's well-being. You got to make them know that you care about them and doing your very best to bring them back to a normal state, you know, if at all possible. You know, I mean, I have had a lady come to me. She traveled 2 hours. She asked me, I met her at a barbecue, and she said, is there such thing as living without pain? And I'm very truthful. I said, no, but you don't have to be in the amount of pain that you're in.
You can take it down. You can take it down.
Okay? And she traveled to me. And she was just so amazed. But that made me feel so honored. I mean, when I do massage therapy, I look at myself not as a therapist, as a technician. You know, because that is my ultimate goal. To help you feel the best that you could feel, you know. And, like, I get a lot of customers that say, okay, well, I just want relaxation. I'm like, really? I'm like, you don't have no pain? You know, let me do my job, you know. And which is awesome, which is really awesome. And, again, I wouldn't change it for the world at all.
Well, you know, the highest level that anyone can get to is service, you know, and I can tell that you're in your ministry place and you're in a service place. So I'm going to ask you, I think you answered this question already, but for the audience, who is a good referral? Who is someone that you want to see have referred to you?
Again,
pain, someone who's very busy.
It's people that are in pain that are really out here suffering. You know, like even in the summertime, I was trying to put something together because I am not business oriented. I'm the creative one, you know, so it's hard to do certain things, but I'm learning because this is a learning process as well. But I want to go to different places and just do chair massage for people. I don't want anything from them. Because sometimes there are times to where I could be walking down the street and I look and I see that this person's walking and they're in pain. Right. I could feel that. And I say, I can help that person. I want to help that person. How do I get to these people? You know, and it's hard because, like I said, I'm just starting out. I have no clue of what I'm doing. Actually, my thing is I want the people that are in pain, and I want to make an impact in their life.
I think you absolutely know what you're doing. You know, remember that song, Cornelius, don't go changing to try and please me? You're right in that space. I believe that all of us have a giftedness that has nothing to do with our earthly existence. Yeah. It is something that we came into this world with. The book of Jeremiah, chapter 13, verses 12 through 14 says, and I knew you before you were in your mother's womb, and I have plans for you, right?
I believe that.
So, you know, that means that you existed in a spiritual dimension before you came into a physical dimension and came here with some gifts that are unique only unto you. I think one of those is for you. It just kind of spills out as being a caregiver. And I could see Kia smiling. Says, my mom takes care of me real good. Kia, what do you have to say about your mother's profession? You proud of her? Her time. It's definitely worth it. I hear you.
Yeah. I'm feeling pretty good.
You got to press the button, Kia. Or nobody out there will hear all the wonderful things you said. So let me ask you a question now. How long did you have to go into get your certificate?
It was about a year and 4 months, I would say. A year and 4 months. And the incredible thing is that you know how every time you try to go forward, something kind of pushes you back. Well, I came up with pneumonia. Yeah. So I'm in the hospital, and my teacher, Miss Maida McDonald, amazing woman, she drove all the way to bring me the paperwork that I needed so that way I wouldn't be discredited from school, you know. So, once I finished with that, some other things happened, but I kept going. I kept focused. I call it my blinders, because I wanted it so bad. I was just here with everything. I would sleep with my books and everything like that. But,
Well, you just discovered the secret to success and wealth in the world. The secret that is right there in the beginning of the most popular personal empowerment book ever written, which is called Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill. The secret to success in there, Napoleon Hill says, the secret to all wealth and success is a burning desire for anything. Burning desire for anything. That when it's overcoming you like that, it's gonna happen.
Yeah.
It's gonna happen. I wanna thank, I think Tracy be just fine. I wanna thank Tracy and Kia. What college do you go to, young lady?
Rutgers University in New
Brunswick. The R is in the house.
Yes.
I'm glad to have you. You keep on doing well. We will not accept anything. Your report card should just sound like this. You don't want nothing else, right? That's your report card should sound like a big That's the only thing that should be on it. That's what we're trying to see. We want to thank Tracy Wilcox. We want to thank my sister Dawn Marable Fields, who's sitting up at home with that mucus all up in her. It'll let you go one of these days, but you keep on fighting, sis. We want to have you back in the studio. I know that little thing that's going around has got you for a minute, but you're going to break free. And all of my friends down at Roselle Health Plus, where the Matthews Broadcast Inner Circle reception will be at 125 East 2nd Avenue in Roselle. We'll be down there about 8:30. Lisa said she has some surprises, gifts, jewelry, all kind of stuff. And you guys are welcome to come down if you wish. All you have to do is follow us down to Roselle. We have a group of strategic partners, friends, and guests there that are going to keep on people that we want to refer you to, connect you with. So anyone out there, if you want to come and meet some great business people, do some great business, but be in a positive circle of people focused on prayer, focused on light, focused on uplifting each other. Join us tonight at 125 East 2nd Avenue at Roselle Health Plus, Keith Broadway's business, and all of the UBA crowd, the Inner Circle crowd will be there, and we look forward to eating some of Mary Washington's great food. Mary's got the taco salad prepared for me and hopefully a little bit of pasta, so I can't wait to get down there. We will be right back with our next guest. Thank you again, Tracy. Thank you again,
so
Kia,
for
coming. We're glad to have you.
Mm-hmm.
Matthews Broadcast. This is the compliments are just flying around in here like wind. So hopefully I'll get a compliment as well at some point. And so before we introduce our guests, I want to pay some bills here. All of our friends down at 125 East 2nd Avenue at Roselle Health Plus, the Inner Circle members and also the members of UBA want to share with everyone, if you are ready to take your business to the next level today, accept no substitutes, join UBA. UBA is an organization that is dedicated to having dollars circulate in urban communities. Its members refer business to each other so that we keep those dollars in our community circulating as often as we can. If you want to find out more about UBA, come to 125 East 2nd Avenue Roselle tonight with us, or you can call 908-259-5012, 908-259-5012 for UBA. You will talk to the great Kim Falk. I hope you're listening, Kim, but more importantly, I hope your husband Maurice is listening, because, you know, of the two of you, you, I think, are the person who is really in control of that relationship. So, Kim, Queen Kim, that's right, you are the boss lady. Mr. G's Restaurant here in Patterson, where good friends meet, greet, and eat. He's at 455 East 18th Street in Patterson. You can call them at 973-782-4020, 973-782-4020. One important note here, all roads lead to 1 Penn Plaza East tomorrow, which is New Jersey Transit headquarters. 14 years ago, New Jersey Transit committed what we think is a mighty injustice on our brother, friend, and mentor. It caused him to lose a business that was worth at that time a little over $1.3 million. And so we have engaged New Jersey Transit in a conversation and told them in the public that no public agency paid for by taxpayer dollars should be behaving this way with such a revered member of the African American community. He has been in business for 54 years, and so we'll be at the New Jersey Transit headquarters tomorrow with a contingent of his friends and supporters demanding justice for Russell Grady. So if you'd like, come on out. We will be there between 9:30 and 11 o'clock telling the board of directors at New Jersey Transit that Russell Grady deserves justice. We're going to have friends, family, some elected officials. We'll have plenty of press there, including News 12 New Jersey. We will also have Fox News of all people, the Associated Press, North Star News. My good friend Walter Fields of North Star News will be in the building, NAACP, National Action Network, among others that will join us, because we are not going to allow our elder friend and mentor to not be treated fairly, because if he's treated unfairly, you are sure that you and I will be. Patterson, Alpha Digital Imaging, the image doctor himself, Cornelius Hill, sits to my left. You can reach him for images that last a lifetime. Call Cornelius at 973-818-3020, 973-818-3020. Balance Well Health Center, Dr. George and Roth Riley, here in Elmwood Park. You can reach them at 201-794-4500. And Cheyenne Gifts, the gifts that last a lifetime. I think the person who is the owner of that business is in studio tonight. I have to put on my shades. That's what Thaddeus was saying, because that person is definitely shining a little bit. Miss Lisa Thompson, 973-653-6333. So we're going to get on to our guest, Mr. Thaddeus Hammond,
yes,
who is a contractor who does home improvements anywhere in New York, New Jersey area, I take it.
The New Jersey area.
I heard he's insured for up to $1 billion worth of $1 million, $10 million. You know, he's insured for a lot of money.
Yeah.
That means that when Thaddeus does your work, you can take it to the bank. It's going to be done well, and it's
Absolutely.
Going to be done excellently. We're glad to have you. How long have you been a general contractor,
sir? I have been a general contractor for the last 12 years, and I have been practicing officially for the past 3 years.
Excellent. And what's the specialization of your business?
My specialization is in interiors, kitchens, bathrooms, attics. If you want your kitchen redone, if you want your TV mounted the right way without the wires hanging down, if you have a bathroom that you want redone, I'm the person you need to call.
I feel my money slipping out of my pocket.
Oh, yes, sir.
We need a
Not
lot
Not too
of
much,
work.
Though.
Man. Well, I will say to you that there are plenty of members of the organization that we would love to share with you, that we would love to refer to you, and we will definitely do so. You'll see that tonight when we go down the parkway a little bit. Tell me who's a good referral for you. Who's just like the client that you want?
Somebody like Jerry Moultrie.
Jerry, I feel your checkbook getting short.
Well, he has already been a client, and he has referred me to you, actually. Absolutely. And I must say, if we all have stories of clients that we would have, he is someone that is definitely top notch. You have professional people coming into your house, but as professionals, we also would like clients, the ideal clients, and he's someone who. He tells you what he wants, no nonsense. Either you do it or you hit the road.
That's right.
And he puts the rubber where the road is. He's a customer in this business that puts his demands right in front of you, and you just have to meet them. So what else can you ask for?
That's right. That's right. And that's the thing. You can't go to Jerry's house and expect to get fried chicken after you finish the work.
Oh, absolutely not.
You just got to do the work and go. No, you might get something else, though. She's a client of his as well. They're best friends.
Oh, okay.
She gave him the moniker Super Jerry.
Oh, okay. So the world is small.
Right. But when you go out and do a job, do you first do an assessment of the needs of that?
Yeah, most of the time, actually all of the time, I always do an assessment first, because that's pretty much my business model. Normally, that's what makes my business, I consider it unique.
Mm-hmm.
We can all go back in our lives and see on TV with all of the home improvement shows they have that are endless of the nightmares that people have been going through with contractors and people, all kinds of people in their house and different tragedies. We all have one. And I figured, you know, I just want to give people a sense of ease. We all supposed to be professionals. I want to offer you the professional service. More importantly, I want to win your trust. Because if I'm coming into your house, I should be treating your house with respect. I'm coming into your family, someplace where you and your family lives and pray and do everything. So I'm going to offer that environment the most respect I can possibly offer. So with Taddy and Sons, that's the name of my business, Taddy and Sons Home Improvement and Constructions, we just offer professionalism, that ease that you can know that the job is going to be done right. Your house will not be torn up in shambles. You will be not taken advantage of in terms of with the money that you spend. And ultimately, the worst thing I've heard in contractors and things of that nature, I hear customers say, I'll be glad when these people get out of my house. And as you are anticipating the job to be finished, we do not want that to happen in terms of the professionalism that we offer.
I'm glad to hear that. The person sitting to your left definitely has some requests of you.
Oh, yes, ma'am.
And I'm sure you're going to hear more about that. The passion that I hear in your voice, Thaddeus, I can tell. What drew you to carpentry first and then deciding to be a contractor?
It's a funny thing, because I'm also a musician, and I was told
No, he talks like he got that rhythmic.
It was in the air, huh?
Uh-huh.
I was told that don't do anything in this world that you wouldn't do for free.
Sure.
And I didn't understand what that meant at the time, because coming up, being in college and getting out into the world, you first thing you're looking for is money and a roof over your head, mouth, you know, food in your stomach. But then after a while, once things starting to settle down, I noticed that people a lot of times work in dead end jobs. And what I mean by a dead end job is a job that you do not like to get up to. You dread getting up to. And when you get paid, maybe the pay is okay. Maybe it's not so okay. But at the end of the day, you still have to do that job, and it drains you. So from that, I noticed that people always would ask me to fix stuff. Can you come help fix this toilet? This sink is broke. Sure. You know, and I was just doing it for spare time. But then I realized, hey, I want to learn how to do it right. So I would call professionals to come in, and I would ask them, can I watch you? And I would learn from professionals on my spare time. doing it right, I would have books. I noticed my spare reading. I was told that you can tell what a person is into, what they're really about by look at the books that they read. Look what they do in their spare time. I noticed all my books were construction books. You know, I'm in my spare time reading how to properly wire a receptacle. You know, all of these sort of things. So from that, fast forward, I found myself in school at the local 254 in Kenilworth, the New Jersey Carpenter Training Fund, doing it for free, just learning my craft through my passion. And then, sadly to say, a couple years ago, I lost my grandmother, and that's what sealed it. At her funeral, I met the other side of my family, who are all contractors, and I didn't even know it. So when I go to meet all my family and all of her side of the family, she talks about my great grandfathers and all their brothers. They were all contractors and masons and things. And these were in the 20s and the 30s and the 40s and the 50s, where as a black man in those times, being quote unquote on the wall as a mason was a big thing, because most of us were limited to what they call laboring work, laborers, and that sort of thing. So I found out my grandfather was an architect, bringing home blueprints and on the wall, masonry. And I said, wow. So that's where the name came from. His name is Thaddeus. My real name is Thaddeus Hammond, and I'm the fourth. And his name is Thaddeus, and they call him Taddy. And that's why I named my business from him, Taddy and Sons Construction, out of homage to my grandfather.
That name also is in a lot of cases, an African-American is named after Thaddeus Stevens.
There you go. Abolitionist.
The abolitionist who worked side by side with Frederick Douglass and Abraham Lincoln to get us to fight for our rights in this country. Somehow, some truths always spill out.
Yeah.
Regardless of what we want to do about it, mm-hmm. And I just got that feeling. Just mm-hmm. People's spirit just speaks mm-hmm. to you, mm-hmm. And I'm not at all surprised at where you are. Speaking of the things that people read, kind of tell you something about them. Mm-hmm. I know the person sitting to your left has a book in front of her
Uh-oh.
That she would like to share with people. On that book, Dr. Tracy Lynn. Lisa, tell us who Dr. Tracy Lynn is. We got to move fast, but we want to hear what Dr. Tracy Lynn has to.
Well, Dr. Tracy Lynn started a beautiful company, a multi-level marketing company, and most of the products are gorgeous pieces of jewelry. So I am wearing a fabulous necklace and the matching earrings. I have a gorgeous bracelet and another one. And so I started selling Tracy Lynn jewelry because a friend of mine wore a piece and I fell in love with that piece. So I went to the website to order just that one piece and realized that I wanted every single piece on the website. The jewelry is exquisite and the prices are phenomenal. It's very, very reasonable for the extreme quality that you get. So I had to become a representative because that's the only way I could get every single piece without blowing my budget. So I have been happily selling the jewelry for a few months now. I've thrown a few parties. So I'm looking for customers who'd like to wear beautiful bling bling like I'm wearing, and who would like to throw a party so they can get their jewelry free. So, or if they want to become a representative like myself, then they can sell the jewelry and have a substantial income for as long as they want to be financially independent. So if someone wants to contact me about this business, my phone number is 973-653-6333. That's 973-653-6333. And my website is www.tracylynnjewelry.net/Lisa J. Thompson. And that Tracy Lynn is TracyLynn. So it's www.tracylynnjewelry.net/Lisa J. for Jeanette. J is my middle name, Lisa J. Thompson. But, you know, I can't say enough about how beautiful the jewelry is. I don't know if this camera is capturing how gorgeous it is, but the pieces are so exquisite and so different, and you're just not going to see them on everybody. And it's not dollar store jewelry. That's not the price, and that's not the quality. They're absolutely gorgeous. Every person that I have sold to has bought another piece and another piece and another piece. So I am so proud to represent this company. I love what the company stands for, too.
I am so happy that you are happy. So we're going to sign off this evening. Thank you, Lisa, for that description of Tracy Lynn, African-American woman.
Absolutely.
Who owns that business, and they're doing very well. We ask that God bless them, continue to bless them. We thank you, Thaddeus Hammond, for being on.
Thank you so much.
We want to make sure that we give you plenty to do.
Yes, sir.
In our household and also in the Urban Business Association. We will be seeing you very shortly, friends. I know that you are all descending on 125 East 2nd Avenue. And as we do at the end of every Matthews broadcast, we remind you there are two types of people in the world, dreamers like you and dream killers. Run from the first and embrace the second. So until tomorrow evening, this is Stan Matthews signing off, but not signing out. We will be back tomorrow night at 7 o'clock. This is the Matthews Broadcast, Empowerment Broadcasting on 91.7 FM and streaming worldwide at www.gemsradio.net. Good night.
Good night.
Good night.